overarching philosophy, to put it into one phrase, is learning to live with difference. So whether we talk about difference, religious difference, whether we talk about socioeconomic difference, difference between peers, difference between siblings, essentially it is difference that leads to conflict in a small way or in a big way, right? I don't agree with your ideology, you don't agree with mine, and we're not being able to, we're not being able to accept it, and we're not even being able to respect it. We as adults, as parents, as educators, what are we doing? Are we providing the necessary exposure that leads to sensitization, right? That's all that is required. They just need their world to be opened up to other areas, to other worlds. And that was the felt need, actually, to open up that world for a certain segment of humans. The essential idea behind what we do is to provoke thinking, to provoke, to inspire questioning. To make the audience that we are working with to look within themselves, which is something that doesn't happen within our education system. It doesn't allow it, because we still, of course, there's some very, very wonderful schools that are doing great work now, but largely within our education system, we actually discourage questioning. Forget about, inspiring questioning and encouraging it. It's actually frowned upon. How do we define violence? It's not always just the physical act of beating somebody up, right? Yes. There's so much more to it. There's so much more to it, and it's such a deep issue that it can sometimes take a lifetime to actually practice nonviolence. We brought 15 students, young students, from near the line of control, not from proper Srinagar. These were students who had never stepped out of the valley, 9 out of 10. Their process of education was also very sporadic with all the curfews and everything that happens. In that process, they're talking about their lives. The students from here are talking about their lives, their aspirations, their realities, and the students from there are talking about their lives and their aspirations and their realities. And both are learning from each other. And in that sense, is where we hope the sensitization is happening for the students here. And for those who come from there, it's the much required exposure, which, we hope does wonders to their conscience. The essential idea of history for peace, which is not, mind you, is not, the idea itself is not yet successful at all, but we're working towards it. It's a network for history teachers between India, Pakistan, and Bangladesh. We pick the topic of the annual conference based on what the urgent need to talk about is, right? So last year we spoke about the Constitution. And this year the schedule was in August for democracy. The moment you do respect difference, this whole concept of Ahimsa, I think, just becomes a way of being, isn't it?
Yes.
So we don't consciously talk about violence or non-violence, but we very consciously develop all our projects with the issue of addressing mindsets.